If you want to know how I turn my girl Natalee Linez into Representative AOC, keep watching. So I'm just checking to see what her skin feels like. It feels amazing because she has perfect baby skin. And she already has her skincare on, so we're just going to give her a spritz of the e.l.f. Essential Oil Mist, the Rose. And then we are going to luxuriously prime her skin with the Guerlain primer. I do not know how to say it. This primer is honestly incredible, and I'd say worth the price tag. I'm gonna put it on with this fluffy brush. Priming all the way down to her neck. Next, I'm gonna go in with this By Terry Illuminating CC Serum. Not only is it going to give her face a nice tinted bronze glow, but it's going to give me a gorgeous base for the concealer. Next up, I am highlight concealing with NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in Ginger. AOC happens to also love NARS Concealer and NARS products. She uses a NARS foundation as well. I'm blending the concealer all the way up to where the tear duct and upper bridge of the nose is. Next, I'm going to mix up caramel and ginger to make the perfect shade to conceal the rest of Natalee's face. Next, I'm going to powder her cheekbones before I do any contour work, but I also realized that I wanted to do a cream contour next because AOC does a Fenty cream contour. So normally I wouldn't powder before using cream contour because I don't like to cream over powder products, but the Fenty Mocha Match Stick is such a genius product that it can go over powder as well, especially when you use it with a stippling brush like this. After laying down the contour with stippling brush, I'm taking the same brush I used to lay down primer and the CC serum, and I'm just buffing any harsh edges. And now taking my gorgeous Scott Barnes contour palette, and I'm using Sliced to lightly go over the cream contour with a big, fluffy, soft powder brush. Next, I'm using glycerin soap to prep the brows. I just run it through with some water and a spoolie, and I'm taking some brow powder from my Anastasia palette and really just filling in the tail end of her brows because she has such perfect, gorgeous, thick brows. I only need to do the end, and I'm taking mostly taupe and then mixing in a little bit of ash gray to fill them in super naturally. I'm priming with the primer that comes with my Dior Show and the Neutrals palette. I really like that primer, with a fluffy brush. And before I did go in with shadow, I did powder down a little bit. I'm taking this burnt orange and sort of burnt sienna color with a really big flat MAC brush just to lay everything down. Big wash of color on the lids. By the way, this eyeshadow palette I'm using is called the Tartus Pro palette and is one of my favorite neutral palettes of all time. And AOC also happens to love Tarte eyeshadow. So I'm just taking a little bit of the same colors and going under her lid for drop shadow, and then now using the gold shimmer from the Dior Show Amber Neutrals palette and highlighting her lid just in the center. Now I'm going to bronze the rest of her face with Hoola bronzer and a big fluffy powder brush. I'm using a waterproof brown liner pencil. I actually don't really like this one that much, so I wouldn't highly recommend it for this specific look. But I'm just going to tight line right now to line her eyes and then really just go towards the outer parts of her eyes to do a soft brown wing and then wing it out with just literally the same brow brush I used. I like to use the same brushes if I can when I'm doing makeup, just to eliminate the time of cleaning brushes and just honestly because it's easier. In between, I'm also using a flat shader brush just to give the ends a little bit of a smoke effect. Now I'm going to highlight, and this one is by Illamasqua and the color is Deity. Highlighting the inner corners and the brow bone and the cupid's bow and all that good stuff. Mascara I'm using is Makeup Forever Smoky Lash. And I'm going to paint her lashes with the mascara. Don't forget to comb your lashes because chunky lashes are gross and ratchet and no one wants that. For bottom mascara, I'm going to use this tiny Korean spoolie to get all the baby lashes with a nice coated. Taking a little bit of that shimmer shade from the Dior Show palette from before and just going in the middle of the eyes, open the eyes up more. Now I'm using a NYX Wonder Pencil in the lightest shade to open her eyes up even more in the waterline. I decided not to do a blush but just take a little bit more bronzer and put that on the cheeks because AOC doesn't really wear blush, it seems, most of the time, just bronzer. Doing some last step concealing and then concealing all over the top of the top and bottom of the lip line to prepare for the iconic red lip. Now I'm lining the lips with a Morphe lip liner and the color is Scarlet. I'm starting at the Cupid's bow and then the middle part of the bottom lip to map out the lip shape. That's usually what is the easiest, that's the easiest way for me to line lips on other people. I personally like to color the lips in after I line them. And then I'm using the Milk Micellar Gel Remover to keep the lines really clean, which works really well, honestly. And then I'm using these Jouer liquid lip colors. The shades are Watermelon and Cabernet. They gave me more of a just like bright red that matched the lip liner, which is fine because I think it's really, really flattering on Natalee. But AOC usually wears like a darker, more sort of Christmassy red. After filling in the whole lip with the liquid lip, I just conceal the outer part of the lip line with some concealer and a flat concealer brush. And voila. Don't forget to smash a follow at Natalee's Instagram and at my Instagram. Like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you enjoyed watching me turn her into AOC. I'll see you on the next video. Bye.